This is a very important video, and I think it's important because today I'm going to be talking about ego. I'm not saying that I'm an expert at such kind of topics, but I just have some references to share with you guys, or some points, and I thought I'll talk about it. What is ego, and where does it start from? I think ego is a very abused word because there are so many different variants about the ego. I think for most of our Indian audience, you know, ego and attitude mean the same thing, but they're completely different. You can have a good attitude in life, like I do, or you can have a bad attitude in life. A bad attitude in life means you're a closed person and you don't like to listen to new things. You are always talking about your own things. You're unwilling to listen to anybody else. And having a bad attitude is somebody who's not very friendly, who is a bit shut off. Having a good open attitude is somebody who is more appreciating of other people and diverse ideas. So I feel it's kind of good to have a good attitude, not only because people are more likely to want to be your friend or be around you, but it will also help you in work. Often I notice that certain people are shy and a bit reserved. So if you tell them that they have a bad attitude, they can say something like, "Oh, I'm just a little shy," or "No, I don't have a bad attitude. I have no attitude." That's because they mistake attitude and ego as the same damn thing, whereas they are completely different philosophies and different thoughts and different ways of being. A person who has a bad attitude is somebody who is unwilling to reshape themselves to fit the norm of the given situation, who is unwilling to relent from their high horse. A person with a bad attitude thinks their way or the highway. A person with a bad attitude is more likely to make, you know, to not take themselves seriously and therefore not take others seriously. You only take everyone else seriously, and you only really give a fuck when you give a fuck about yourself. If you have an attitude in life which says, "I don't give a fuck about anything," then my friend, you're probably a bit of an idiot who doesn't know any better. I care about all of you guys. I care about even the ones who hate me, the ones who click dislike. I care, man. I can't help but I care, you know. And when I say I care, I mean I give a damn about what you think about me. I do care. And some people say that's my problem, that I care, but I think not caring is such a cop-out. It's for cowards. I think it takes a man to care about everyone, and I am that man. Now, ego. What is ego? Ego is a false sense of self, a false representation of oneself, a false identity, association with one's own identity as something very important. It's a kind of a self-importance which is kind of harmful. Yesterday I was having a conversation with somebody, and he was a good salesman. So he used these words. He said, "I made that sale by massaging the ego of my client," and that is a very important tact to have. Sometimes you have to massage other people's false sense of self-identity in order to get the sale. Now, a guy like me, I'm very conscious about my own ego. So when I'm reminded about it by other people, it could be in the form of, "Oh my God, sir, you are so great, sir. Sir, you are so good. Sir, we love you, sir, da da da." Or someone who says, "Fuck, you're such a good looking guy. Oh my God, you have the best life. I wish I was like you. I wish I could go to the gym." I mean, some of those things are okay, but some of them are a bit over the top. But that, I think that's because I have an issue accepting compliments. And I think I just do because, again, I have a very deep-seated ego. Is ego your friend or is ego your enemy? I think if you get a better understanding of the world around you, if you get a better understanding of yourself, and if you are able to ingratiate other people into your life, I think ego is a very positive thing to have. How does the ego feed itself? How does the ego feed itself? The ego feeds itself by anger and by representation of anger. So sometimes you will notice that if you are angry at someone and it's building in you, you will go and yell at that person, you know, or you will say something to that person, however, you know, rude it could be, however nice it could be, but you were rude to somebody because your ego was a bit butthurt. What does yelling at somebody else do? It strengthens your false belief in yourself. Your false belief in yourself is your ego. So by yelling at somebody else, you might just strengthen your ego. By victimizing, by taking revenge from somebody, by trying to ruin somebody else's mood, you know, all of these things are ways of, you know, strengthening your individual perception of ego. So don't do it. And you will notice sometimes, you know, there are two parts of you. One part of you feels very happy when you yell at someone and you're like, who is this guy who's yelling at someone else? When you're talking about yourself in third person. And the other is when you feel, my God, why did I say such rude things to that person? Later you're like, oh my God, why did I do that? So that is the real you. That is the part of you which is bereft of ego. And it's important to associate that. Many people feel they have no ego, and that could be right. I think we don't have many egoistic people living around us. But if you're in your 30s, my friend, I think it's high time you let the ego go. I'll tell you an example of group ego. Recently, Kunal Pandya, you know, he was in some IPL game and he took water, and instead of giving it back to the guy, he threw a water bottle at the 12th man. Now people are like, oh my God, how can Kunal Pandya do this? Why is he so rude? Who the fuck does he think he is? Why does he have such a bad ego? Why does he have such a bad attitude? Oh my God. And then what happens? The collective voice of masses gets together to fuck one guy up. For example, Twitter is full of group ego. That is the most unhealthy form of ego. You know, there was once I was at a... So that's not very good to have a group ego or be a part of group ego. It's important to identify when you are being a part of the group ego. If you're sitting with your five or six friends, you are more likely to bitch about the seventh friend who was not there. That is an example of group ego. Be the bigger man and never say anything about somebody behind their back, something that you wouldn't say to their face. That's again a part of being a man. And I would rather be a man than be someone who has a false association with oneself. Now, whatever I'm saying, it might be a few bounces over the top of your head. But this was my part one of my series of ego. I just wanted to talk about it and have a general video. I want to give one more example, guys, before I go. What was that example I wanted to give, man? Again, so like I said, just to recap all of everything I said, ego is nothing but a false sense of self which people live with on this earth. Some people feel that they need to have some ego in order to progress in life. Do you need to have some ego in order to progress in life? Yes. Will having an ego make you a successful person? Maybe yes, because if you don't have any ego, you're not going to be driven to invest in your own in company, in your own corporation. But when I say your own corporation, it's whatever your name is. Supposing your name is Lalu Yadav. Okay, so let's say your name is Lalu Yadav. If Lalu Yadav has an ego, he will invest in Lalu Yadav company. If Lalu Yadav doesn't have an ego, he may just be like, oh my God, I should probably go work for somebody, or oh my God, I should just do what my father did and never get out of it. So don't get me wrong, it is important to have an ego at a certain stage in life. It's very important, because once you have an ego, you really learn things about how the world works and about yourself and your own identification with your cause, which propels you forward, and so forth, So it's important to have an ego also, but more important than that is to have an open door attitude in life, is to have a good attitude in life. A bad attitude is a representation of ignorant people. A bad attitude plus ego is a very, very bad combination, because it just shows naivety on your part. And why am I talking about ego today? Because like I said, somebody said yesterday that he had to massage the customer's ego to make the sale. Some people are good at that selling technique, you know, where you compliment the other person. Some people are bad. I'm kind of good at that. I'm very aware of people's ego, you know, and I can turn a blind eye to their weaknesses, you know, and I can compliment them subtly on their good, because I tend to see the good in people in any case. So for me to make a sale and to just compliment the other person is very easy. I love complimenting people. It's a hobby. You should try it sometime. Anyways, I'm out of here, dude. I'll see you when I do. Cheers.